हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। होपफुली यू आर वेरी वेल। इन माय लास्ट क्लास द पोएम सॉनेट 18 वाज फिनिश्ड, यू नो वेरी वेल। इन माय लास्ट क्लास प्रीवियस डे थर्ड क्वार्टर एंड द कंक्लूडिंग कपलेट ऑफ द पोएम वर डिस्क्राइब्ड वर एक्सप्लेन्ड। ओके, होपफुली यू हैव अंडरस्टूड, यू हैव फेल्ट, यू हैव रियलाइज्ड द थीम ऑफ द पोएम, द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पोएम लाइन बाय लाइन। टुडे द फेज ऑफ क्वेश्चन आंसर, बिफोर गोइंग थ्रू द फेज ऑफ क्वेश्चन आंसर फॉर योर बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, फॉर योर स्मूथ रिकॉलिंग और रिमेंबरिंग। इन अ नट सेल टुडे आई एम गिविंग यू फॉर यू द होल थीम सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ द पोएम इन अ नट सेल इन शॉर्टकट। सो इन सॉनेट 18 यू केम टू नो दैट विलियम शेक्सपियर records, inscribes or carves the excellent, outstanding, unparalleled, youthful beauty of his young friend who was the Earl of Southampton or Pembroke, P-E-M-B-R-O-K-E, William Hubbard or Mr. W-H. Okay? Shakespeare compares the excellent loveliness of his friend to a beautiful summer's day. In the course of comparison, the poet discovers so many weak points or negative points about the beauty of summer. Firstly, the poet compares the beauty of his friend to a beautiful, lovely summer's day. And secondly, thereafter, the poet is sure the beauty of his friend will easily overtake the beauty of summer's day. So in the course of comparison, the poet finds out several shortcomings or faults of summer season. Firstly, the poet has found out that summer is a season of very brief validity. The season of summer carries the deadly dance of rough winds or stormy winds, which mercilessly destroy the beautiful, soft, cozy buds of the month of May of summer. Okay? Another weak point of summer, you came to know that summer has the scorching heat of the sun. Okay, that is intolerable for all human beings, for all the animal society and trees and plants. And also you came to know that often the beautiful rays of the sun are also dimmed, decreased by the overcast sky. When the sky is cloudy or overcast, then the beauty of the sun, the golden rays of the sun, that is the gold complexion of the sun, is decreased or diminished. Okay? Then also you came to know that the poet is describing every fair from fair sometime declines. Means every lovable object, every beautiful object of nature mother or on this earth, with the passage of time, with the advantage, with the progress of time, with the advent of time, becomes the subject or matter of decay. Every lovable object of nature mother or every beautiful object of nature mother, every human being on this earth must be decayed or must be changed, must be destroyed with the advent of time or with the progress of time. Okay? The poet also indicates that by chance or by fate, by destiny, every lovable object, every beautiful object must be destroyed one day, as if all the beautiful objects of nature mother are predestined, okay, previously determined to be decayed, to be changed, to be lost. Clear? By the law of nature, every lovable object, every beautiful object, every beautiful young body, human body must be destroyed with the passage of time. But the beauty of the poet's friend will never be faded, will never be lost, because it has been carved, it has been recorded in the eternal lines of poetry. The lines of poetry are immortal, the lines of poetry are deathless, eternal, because it exists ages after ages, generation after generation. So the poet is sure, as long as human civilization exists, mankind will read this sonnet 18. And when this sonnet 18 will be read by people, people will recall about the excellent beauty of the poet's friend. So the poet has said that the beauty of his friend is like eternal summer. In nature's breast, summer is not eternal, summer is temporary. It has no permanence. But the beauty of the poet's friend is everlasting, is ever glowing. It has a great perpetuality because it has been carved in the eternal lines of poetry. Up to the existence of human civilization, people will enjoy, people will increase the new explanation, the new warmth of the poet's friend. So in the heart of people, the poet's friend will be ever green, ever youthful, ever alive. So the poet is sure even the onslaughts of time and death will be failure to vanish, to diminish this excellent human beauty from this earth. Even the onslaughts of time and death will be failure to fade, to diminish this excellent beauty of the poet's friend from this earth, because it has been carved in the eternal lines of poetry. So you think how greatly successful Shakespeare is in his beautiful enterprise or attempt, because Shakespeare or Shakespeare's friend died from today at least 400 years before. Today in this 21st century also, when we are going through the poem Sonnet 18, we are recalling, we are thinking, we are feeling, realizing about the excellent liveliness of the poet's friend. So really Shakespeare's friend is ever alive in our heart. So the attack of death, the omnipotent figure death, is also failure to walk with his black shadow in the life of the poet's friend. So the poet's friend will never walk into the black shadow of death. So the black shadow of death is also here failure to cover up, to capture the poet's friend. Okay? So even the death will not be so proud, will not be so boastful of killing the poet's friend. So finally the poet has concluded very beautifully. Up to the existence of human civilization, the poet's eternal friend, the poet's eternal friend, the poet's friend's eternal beauty will be everlasting in the heart of people. As poetry is deathless, as poetry has no death, so the excellent beauty of the poet's friend has no death. The poet's friend, Shakespeare's friend, Mr. William Hubbard or Mr. W.H. is ever alive, is ever youthful, is ever excellent in our heart through the art of poetry. For the very reason the poet took the excellent device of art of poetry, through the lines of verses, through the lines of poetry, the poet has immortalized very beautifully his friend in this world. Okay? So the poet's friend is really everlasting, really ever glowing in our heart forever and ever. So it is a beautiful effort, beautiful enterprise of the poet Shakespeare to make his friend immortal on this earth. So Shakespeare's great love and affection for his friend is idealized here as a thing of joy forever. So Shakespeare's full heart for his beautiful friend is revealed here without any doubt. His love is idealized here as a thing of joy forever. For the very reason, Sonnet 18 by nature has become a beautiful, great love poem in the world of English literature. When the question will come, evaluate the poem Sonnet 18 as a love poem, the explanation will go in this way. Shakespeare's true love, great love, real love, heartful love for his friend, affection, trust, all have been poured here with his full heart. For the very reason the poem has become a great love poem in the poetry of English literature. Okay? Now the question answer phase will be started. Today I will give you the questions, council prescribed questions, very, very important questions that come in the final exam from this beautiful poem. Firstly, I am giving you the questions. Today I will pass you the questions, objective questions and the long questions or broad questions from this poem that occasionally come in the final exam. You will try to write down the answers of these questions. Today I will not discuss about the answers of the questions. You will write by yourselves the answers of these questions. In my next class, I will explain the answers of those questions. And opening your exercise books, you will check the answers what will be given by me in my next class. Today I am giving you only the questions. It is your task home task, you will write down the answers in your exercise books. Okay, next day I will give you the answers and questions I am giving. First question, very important, what objective questions, what type of poem is Sonnet 18? What type of poem is Sonnet 18? Okay, number two, to whom is the poem Sonnet 18 addressed? Whom is the poem Sonnet 18 by William Shakespeare addressed to? Clear? Next question, next objective, third. What does Shakespeare compare his young friend to? To what does Shakespeare compare his young friend? Clear? How are the darling birds hacking? As for the poem Sonnet 18. How are the darling birds shaken? As for the poem Sonnet 18 by Shakespeare. Next question. What do you mean by summer's lease? What is summer's lease? Clear? Next. What do you mean by the eye of heaven? What is mean by the eye of heaven in the poem Sonnet 18? Next question. What do you mean by nature's changing course? What is meant by nature's changing course in the poem Sonnet 18 by Shakespeare? Clear? Next question. What does Shakespeare mean by every fair from fair sometime declines? What does the poet mean by the announcement every fair from fair sometime declines? Very important question. Okay. Next one. What does Shakespeare mean by eternal lines? What is meant by eternal lines? Next, what does Shakespeare mean by eternal lines? Complete. Oh, sorry, next one. So long lives this. Quotation. So long lives this. Question. What is this? What does the poet mean here by this? Next question. This gives life to thee. Who is the? What does life mean here? Next question. What will make the beauty of the poet's friend eternal? What will make the beauty of Shakespeare's friend eternal on this earth? Okay. Next one. What shall death not brag of? What shall death not brag of? Next one, how is the gold complexion of the sun dimmed? How is the gold complexion of the sun dimmed in the poem Sonnet 18? Next, how is every fair from fair declined? How is every fair from fair declined? Last question, why has death no control over the beauty of the poet's friend? Why has death no control over the beauty of Shakespeare's young friend? These are the objective questions. Now follow the broad questions, 6 marks long questions. There are main 3 questions from this poem. First one, flat question. How does Shakespeare compare the beauty of his young friend in the poem Sonnet 18? How does William Shakespeare compare the beauty of his young friend in Sonnet 18? Okay. Next one. Quoted question. Line question. But thy eternal summer shall not fade. Very important question. VVI. But thy eternal summer shall not fade. Whose eternal summer is referred to here? What is eternal summer? Why will it not fade? I'm repeating. Whose eternal summer is referred to here? What is meant by eternal summer? Why will it not fade? But question 1 plus 1 plus 4. Last one. Quoted question. This gives life to thee. Very last announcement of the poet. What does this refer to? Who does thee refer to? THEED. How does this give life to thee? What question 1 plus 1 plus 4. These are the questions. You will write down the answers by yourself as your home task. In my next class, I will explain about the answers of these questions. Taking your exercise book, you will only just check the answers. Okay? The answers, the question sheet also you will get on your phone screen, mobile phone screen. because the photocopy of this paper will be given to you. Okay, you will also follow the questions from this page also. Today up to here. Thank you much. Bye.